Hey guys and gals, I'm Pal, and this is Nova, and this is Pal's Play Wind Waker. Last time on this thing, we defeated Mulgaera and got the third to last heart piece. Yeah.
Beautiful.
That was very off key. Also, there was a headstone here, but it died. Is that all we need to do?
Yeah.
Oh, we should probably explain what we're doing. In this hole, there is a Triforce chart, which will lead us to one of the pieces of Triforce, which there, this gives me no indication. There are eight?
Yes.
Eight pieces of Triforce. So we're going to be getting one of the charts now. There's also a heart piece in here, so it's two for the price of one.
Grandma.
Thank you for the Josh Jepson reference. No, you have no clue who that is, do you?
No.
Wow. She's sheltered, kids. She doesn't watch any of the YouTubes. And I get to tell her all about the YouTubes. What does this say? The Savage Labyrinth from Pikmin, apparently. Deep in the never-ending darkness, the way to the golden shard you seek awaits. Okay, thanks. I believe you. So,
and just to clarify, this is Triforce chart number 6.
That is actually important.
Because they are numbered, thankfully.
Yeah, they are. Thank goodness. This feels a lot like Okami, because I had to do this in Okami three times. Three times.
Why? Did you die?
No, there are three of these in Okami.
Oh, my.
And they're you guys would agree that they were harder than the final boss. By far. Oh, hi, Mini Blitz.
No, you always defeat those guys with your skull hammer.
No, I kind of want to see how far I'm going to go without getting hit.
Well, then why didn't you get the chicken soup sword?
I thought about it, but I just want to start the episode. I didn't want to drink chicken soup and then go get more chicken soup. Okay, is that all of you? Come on. There you are. Seriously, why don't they just swarm me all at once? So this episode, I guess I could say, isn't required to watch for the story. In fact, I kind of expect people to just read the description. Ow, there's my first hit. Read the description, see the thumbnail, and then skip it. Because it's just fighting. But also that means I get to talk about stuff. Like Link Between Worlds! Which I finished.
In what, 2 weeks?
Week and a half? I got it Christmas. I got it on Christmas, and I finished it yesterday, which would have been the 6th. So yeah, 2 weeks. Sorry. Well, New Game Plus, though. And it was fun. It was very fun. I'm not going to spoil anything, but the story takes some turns that I've never seen any other Zelda game take, which is awesome. Especially when it kind of seemed like a Link to the Past clone.
Mm.
Also, if you were to compare the dungeons from this game and the dungeons from those games, those ones actually knock this out of the park. Which feels like heresy. But it's true. Oh, why did you hit up there? That was weird.
Because you were in the middle of a parry attack.
Come on. There you go. But yeah, it was pretty good. Although, one complaint I have is that the dungeons are short. There are a bunch of dungeons. There are more dungeons than in this game, but they're short.
Is there some interesting stuff between dungeons?
Yeah, there's some pretty interesting stuff. Though, once you get into low rule, which that's not spoilers. Everyone knows about that. Especially with all the fan art of Hilda out there. Once you get into low rule, it does feel kind of like a dungeon to dungeon type thing.
Mm.
But also low rule in some places feels like a dungeon itself, which is fun. So, it's pretty good.
At one point, I looked over your shoulder and saw you playing baseball.
Oh, yeah. There's a baseball minigame in that, and it's pretty fun. It's pretty fun in that it doesn't feel like baseball. It feels kind of wonky. It feels like monkey baseball.
Oh, my word.
It honestly does. Okay, you're dead. So, this will be kind of a cakewalk.
You just jinxed it.
Thank you. I need to jinx it because it's too easy. I mean...
Oh no, you took a quarter heart of damage.
Yeah, I told you. Die! Come on, spin tech! Or not. Do it after they're all dead. I kind of like that lighting, how it's all dark, but they each have torches. That's cool.
And there's a mystical circle of light around Link.
Yeah, there's a spot. Oh, it's Tingle! Makes sense.
Tingle just flying around overhead with a lantern.
And are you dead? Hoo-yah! These guys are funny. So, do you have any, speaking of Zelda games, do you have any hype for Link, not Link Between Worlds, Zelda U?
I honestly haven't seen enough beta pictures to really know what to expect, so there's not much hype for me, honestly.
So this is floor 10. So you didn't see when they played through the game on screen?
No, I don't think so.
Oh. Well, the developers sort of did a let's play of the game a little bit.
Oh.
It looks pretty good. You can pick up random apples from trees and eat them.
Hmm.
But Dave and I both agreed, the game will not be good. So, we had this big discussion. I have not talked about this. We had this big discussion about the perfect Zelda game. And
oh,
we said,
I remember this.
We said, first of all, the only way this game will be any good is if you can pick up random potatoes out of the ground and eat them. So that's the first thing that needs to happen.
Okay.
The second thing that needs to happen is they need to make a Zelda game that is six discs long, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You need to install all of them and get a separate, another Wii U to play it. So you have two Wii U's to play it, right? It has an online feature. It has 50 dungeons.
Are there two extra discs for the online version?
Yes, there are DLC discs.
Okay.
You can't download them, they're too big. And there are 50 bosses. And then 100 more dungeons, all of which their bosses are Goma. There are a bunch of different items which you can upgrade, and you can play multiplayer online with friends and tackle dungeons yourself.
With the two extra discs.
Yes. It's sort of like a dungeon crawler if you do it that way, sort of, so you can have all these people. It's a 3D Zelda title. Like, it's just like this, or Skyward Sword, but with multiplayer. And you get to do stuff, and there are overworld bosses as well.
Uh-huh.
And there are multiple antagonists in the game that sometimes may not have anything to do with each other. And your decisions in the game can affect whether or not they might align or not. So, like, you could have Majora's Mask and Ganon fight together. Or Gurahim wear Majora's Mask or the Fierce Deity's Mask, although I have a theory
about
that.
That would be terrifying.
So, yeah. All this different stuff. And there are a bunch of different, like, final bosses and realms. So you have, not Termina, but you have Hyrule, you have the things from the Oracle's games. Yeah. This is the perfect Zelda title. Hello! So, you know how they have the dark versions of each character, like Dark Link and stuff?
Mm-hmm.
We just fought Dark Gregory, Dark Adrian Beef, Dark Sylvia, Darth Brock, and Dark Claudia.
Wow.
That was all of them. Okay, you die, and you get a boomerang. And you get a boomerang.
You know what you really should be doing is using this, taking this opportunity to use the grappling hook and grind for items.
Oh yeah, you can do that, but do we need items? No, we don't really need items, Nova.
Is there anything joy pendants. When you see Bakulins,
oh,
get joy
pendants.
Oh,
we do need joy pendants. I think we need more than this, too. Speaking of which, this is an indicator on how far we are through the Blue Choo Choo side quest.
How many are there? 12?
15.
15.
So
okay.
We have 6 left. So that's actually pretty nice. We're almost done with that. I'd like to do that after... I'm not sure where we're going to do that. Oh!
How about after this?
We could do that after this.
Oh, no. Get the joy pendant.
Oh, yeah. Let's equip that. Hey, buddy. Thank you.
There you go.
Thank you for your contribution. Sticking Velkaz up here.
He volunteered his tribute.
And thank you. This sword is really powerful. I haven't really mentioned before that we even got the sword. I was just like, oh yeah, story thing. That happened. But it does stuff. It's super powerful.
You know what we should do later on is sell all of the little collectibles like skull necklaces and just see how much we can make off emptying our spoils bag.
That'd be kind of fun. End the game with no collectibles at all.
It might help us for the Triforce quest, too. Make us some money.
Well, to be fair, we have an infinite grinding spot for money. Which we're abusing, by the way, because it's not a glitch, technically.
I mean, Tingle practically tells you about it, so...
Yeah, he does. Man, I feel broken.
Not straight out, though. You have to figure it out. Joy pendant.
Yep. Come here, buddy. Thank you.
Nice aim.
Thank you. I don't think you noticed earlier, but I got up to a pot, and then as the Bokoblin jumped out, I quick draw grappled him. Yeah, it was pretty sweet. Oh boy.
Oh man. Boomerang time.
Oh wait, no, never mind. No. Hello.
Ice arrows.
Really?
Wow.
Really? What?
Why haven't I ever tried the bow on these
guys
before?
Why is it that we've never tried a bunch of different high guys? I am the savior of their people.
They worship you.
Come here, worship me. Ah. Ah. Yes. I am the savior of their kind. Oh, wait. Wrong way. They will cherish me forever, and I will be forever known as... Spife Man. Spives are fun.
Have you ever seen a spife?
Yes. Not in person, but I have. Also, at this point, you guys are like, yeah, wow, I don't have to watch this episode. I don't have to be subscribed to this channel at all. And you're throwing up because, yes, this is as really as droll as you think it is, just going through 50 floors, killing things.
I actually thought that you would cut most of this out, but okay.
Oh, no. I don't do that because... If there's something like this with a Let's Player that I watch, I do watch it. So I know there are people who do. I'm not that unique. But... Die. I'm not that unique, so there are some people who want to watch it, but I also don't expect people to watch every episode, so... This is an optional
now,
video.
Most of the descriptions I've read that you write are more funny than descriptive.
Uh-huh.
How do you expect people to know what the video includes?
Well, that's what I'm going to do for this episode. I'll just have, like, a thumbnail that we're doing something really exciting, and the description will be like, yeah, we finally tackled the hidden final boss! And then the thumbnail will be really cool, but then we'll just do this the entire episode. Now, here's my question. If I stun one of them and get behind it with the grappling hook, can I get anything out of him?
I believe it just bounces off their metal.
Oh. Head. Oh, these things. I hate these things. Okay. You take that in your mustache, and you take that in your mustache. Aw, you jerk! Okay, there we go. Eat that and leave. Oh. And you're dead. Yeah, I don't really like cutting stuff like that out, because it's kind of the majority of a side quest.
True. Besides, except it's a very, very necessary side quest.
Besides, I did three of these in Okami. Okay, no, I have a better idea. Let's make use of my combo. Hello. Oopsie. Okay. Combo time! There we go. Haha! The hammer does work in this game like it does in that game. No. Hit him. Link.
Target him.
Don't snap on. There we go. There we go. That was fun and satisfying. But yeah, this was a good combo back in, when you first get into Low Rule. I guess this is my walkthrough for Link Between Worlds now. When you first get into Low Rule, all the enemies are super stupid powerful. And... You can't really do much, and they insta-pop you, almost, because you don't have that much life. So if you just equip the boomerang and then the hammer, you can stun them from far away, walk up and hit them, and your sword's not that powerful, so your upgraded hammer is. Really good for getting an early game. Okay, let's
go. Which I suppose is kind of nice, because usually the hammers are lame.
Yeah, they are. Almost every single game, including this one, if you think about it, the hammers are just awful. Okay, let me...
Joy pendant.
Ah, oh, fine. I don't want
to. It will come in handy later.
I don't want to cue the dark nut. Okay. This. Although, honestly, at this point, the Master Sword probably does more damage than the hammer. You know?
Well, to some enemies.
That was cool. Okay, I'm gonna defeat this guy just with the hammer. Maybe.
Can you?
Okay, he's gonna swing. No, I don't think I can. No, I don't think I can. Oh, man! That's lame. Now, is it just me, or are Dark Nuts probably the best version of Dark Nuts was the original Zelda title? Would you agree? You can only
best
hit them
as
from
an impossible to defeat.
Yeah, you can only hit them from, is it behind or from the side? I think it's from behind and the side.
Yes.
And it's very hard because you have a short range.
And because usually by the time you get as far as the Dark Nuts, you have almost no health left.
Yeah.
So you have to hide in the doorway and wait for them to walk past.
Yeah, so I would say the most faith, because I actually like that. I like that Cloak and Dagger kind of play style. I would say the best version of that would be Toilet Princess. Would you agree? You have to play incredibly slow, and you have to wait, bide your time for the perfect shot.
For Dark Nuts?
Yes.
Yes.
That's cool. I like it when it's just kind of staring into each other's eyes, as it were, and just trying to get a read on them.
Yeah, because the parry attack on here makes it just like two button presses, and you're behind their defenses.
And they die instantly, and once their swords are gone, so are they.
But in Twilight Princess, the roll attack doesn't go all the way around behind them.
And even if it does, it doesn't necessarily hit them. Although one thing that's really broken in that game is that seriously what you can do is you see one, right? You don't lock onto it at all. You do the running attack that you use to cut down grass, and it kills them.
Mm-hmm.
Also, bomb shoes work really well. Also, are you seeing the wombo combo that this room is supposed to do?
Yeah.
You walk up blindly and they just hit you and blow you up? That's actually pretty nasty. It's a shame that bombs are their weakness.
I have a quick question.
What?
Why are you in control? You just got a whole dungeon.
This is an odd numbered episode.
Oh.
I didn't mention that. I don't really mention that anymore, I guess. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy.
Oh, and also, there's no Tingle because there's no map for this area, so Tingle would not be able to.
Yes, so this is like the first episode. Oh, that's one thing I found out. This Master Sword actually takes off armor without needing the parry attack.
If you just hit it enough times?
Yeah, no, if you just hit it in first place. Now, shielded ones this doesn't work. That's why they're shielded.
Mm.
See, those block. See,
oh,
actually,
I see.
Yeah. So it'll actually take off the armor, apparently. Okay, you told me something which I... Oh, that doesn't work. You told me if I did a direction parry attack, then I could hit them with a roll.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Oh, it didn't work for me.
Well, sometimes the camera angle messes it up.
Okay. And he's dead.
Because, you know, you think you're going to the side, but the camera thinks you're going straight ahead.
Let's walk in here. So what are we on? Probably like room 30?
I hope so.
Oh, wow. We got here quick. I think this is room 30, because this is where we get the chart. So let's just go and do this real quick. Get the spoils of war. Man, we're rich. We're so rich.
No, Tingle's rich.
Oh yeah, I forgot Tingle rules our lives now. Okay. Wind Waker. You like my song?
It was lovely.
And for a reward for my song gets... You gonna guess what it is?
The Triforce chart?
It's a Grammy!
Obviously.
It's a Grammy or a map to a Grammy! We'll get all 8 Grammys soon. That's what they're called, right? Grammys?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, now that we're on this floor, I think it's floor 30. We just use our shield. So we can only do this if we have the mirror shield, and we can actually advance further than we're supposed... Well, not supposed to, but further than the quest would want us to go. And this is the road to getting that piece of heart. Oh my word! Nova...
Oh, snap.
Oh. Okay, fine. I actually never faced these guys. So it's my turn. Die, die, die. Okay. Okay, that's one. Oh my word. Look at the ranks of evil.
Just toss bombs at them.
No, I'm gonna kill him. Kill him with fire. No, do not walk towards me, you creeper. Don't walk. No, don't eat your friend. Don't eat your friend.
That is so creepy. Why do they go to each other?
Why are you eating? What is with your head? Okay. Okay, now you.
Run.
Yes!
Oh my word.
Okay, there are two here, but I think I can do it.
What does the boomerang do?
Nothing. Oh, snap. No, it worked last time. Yes! I will live life dangerously. Oh, he can't get me. He can't get to me. He can't get to me. Practice that melee skill. Okay. When I said melee skill, it was because Mewtwo King came out with a method to button mash faster than anything. He came up with the best scientific method for button mashing.
Mm-hmm.
And it... How do you kill these guys?
Deku Leaf.
Okay. You have to hit A and B as fast as you can. Because if you do that, it'll actually go faster than any other version of button mashing.
So if you want to hit... What?
If you
want
to hit buttons as fast as you can, it's A and B, alternating.
Okay.
So you just move your thumb from one to another. And that is the best way to button mash. And yes, guys, button mashing is technically a technique, because if you... if you're stunned in League, no. If you're grabbed, then you can button mash to get out. Yeah, don't think League physics. Think Smash physics.
I'm actually thinking Mario Party physics, because you know that one minigame called Manic Mallets?
Oh,
that
yeah.
We could never win? Could you use that method to win that minigame?
Yes. We have the purple choo-choo. He's right over here. And he's pretty much immune like Boo. Oh, wait, that got the song wrong. I wrote a song for when we originally saw these guys, and I wrote it down, and I don't remember the tune that went with it. Okay, you ready? Die. There, you, and then you? There we go. We have the purple choo-choo. He is right over here. He's pretty much immune like Boo-hoo. And he's never even had a fear. In one weary battle day, they saw the light of day. And just when I got a shield, I sure threw them down and... They didn't stay... I don't know. Oh, hi. Is there light? There is. Okay. How is our light this far down? Actually, this is a good question, Nova. Nova?
Hmm?
How is there light this far down? We're under the ocean by this point.
I know what it is.
What?
It's glowworms on the ceiling.
Glowworms on the ceiling. No, don't Obviously. Disappear. Oh my goodness, no. Actually, this is not bad. Goodbye. Okay, you. Okay, you're dead. And... You in your yellow pajamas, your yellow onesie. Man, these guys all were on a slumber party, and they all died at the slumber party, and...
You ruined the slumber party.
I ruined the slumber party by forgetting the groceries.
Wait, before you go down the hole, look up. See where the light's coming from.
It's a hole. It's a hole in solid rock. There isn't even a hole there. It's just light. It's Tingle.
It's glowworms.
It's Tingle. I'm pretty sure it's Tingle. But I ruined the slumber. Oh, hi. Wait, are they're just three this time? Is that the new thing? Oh, that's lame.
Ice arrows.
I don't know. This? Actually, I think... Nope! I think ice arrows kills them in one go? Does they fall? Yes, it does. That's broken. And you get frozen! Wow. Good suggestion, Nova.
Thank you.
Okay, come here. Yes, I'm the savior of your people. I feel like... First of all, I have spiky pants. Second of all, I feel like I just killed the Bulbman mother.
Yeah.
Poor Bulbman. The worst combination. Actually, it is the worst combination because... Hey, Moblin! Mo, get over here! Ha! You kill him for me! You kill him for me!
Why does it look so much taller?
It is taller. It gets bigger when it does this. Ha! You kill him for me, buddy! Yes, kill him! Yes! Thank you. So, are you done? Okay, now you are.
That was really creepy.
You didn't notice that they get bigger when they scream?
No.
Okay.
But I mean, he just seemed to keep growing.
Okay, you're dead.
It's still alive.
Is it?
I think so.
No, it's not. Dude, imagine if they had a random chance of getting back up.
Oh, man.
That would be cool. Or even better, imagine if they... There needs to be an enemy like this. Oh, man. Yeah, there does. An enemy like the Weeping Angels.
Oh,
please.
No.
I want this.
They would have to rate the game
that would be
T or something.
More enemies need to use the Weeping Angels idea. I know Bioshock does it once. In one brief area. What? What? Nova.
Nothing.
Okay. They do it in one brief part in Bioshock, and that's it. And it was really cool and really scary when they did it, but no other game does that. It's fun.
In what way did they do it? Was it with statues?
Yes. You walk into this, there's a secret room full of statues, and you go in, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you get something, and when you get the treasure in the room, and when you turn around, there's a statue in the entrance where you came in, and it wasn't there before, and its arms are over its head. And then you walk around, you're trying to get a better angle, and there's another one. And as they move out of things, more of them spawn. Also, this is like the lantern team comp. Like, okay, we need a slumber party. We need flashlights so we can put on a light show. And we need spears so we can pretend to be the Tiki Men.
The Tiki Men?
The Tiki Men. Okay, I can't do the combo here.
So, in Bioshock, what were the statues of?
People.
Oh, man.
Yeah. There's this one creepy guy named, was it Cohen? I've never played the game, by the way. I just watch YouTube.
a lot.
Yeah, there's this one guy named, I think it's Sanders Cohen, I think. And he turns real people into statues. And if you beat him, blood spurts out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's actually pretty cool. I kind of want to play a different horror game than FNAF on this channel.
You mean a real horror game?
FNAF is real. Get over here. Get over here. Join the slumber party. Come here. There you go. Oh, where'd you come from? Okay. Here. No, I don't want you at the slumber party. I want other guy. See, we went bowling, and this guy didn't get to bowl the full eight frames, and so we're going to bowl the full eight frames right here. Come here. Come here.
Pretty sure you bowl more than 8 frames.
No, not with this. This guy can't handle any more than 8, but he wants more than 8, and we don't let him have more than 8. He's really strange.
Mm-hmm.
So we go home to the slumber... I don't know what I'm talking about. Oh, boy. How was this a good idea? How was this, Nova, a good idea? These guys and them. Okay, what would you say the ultimate team comp would be for enemies here? What enemies naturally have synergy?
Okay, re-deads, without a doubt, are in this team comp.
Are they?
Yes.
Okay.
Because of the stun factor.
Ooh, how about re-deads and these guys? And the skull, and these things?
Ooh.
Yeah. And there's
so
no-
you have something that kind of comes back from the dead.
Yes.
And then you have something that is dead and takes a long time to make dead again.
Yes, I like this idea.
And what would you add? Something small and pesky to make it even more difficult?
Not bomb juice, because that would kind of ruin the whole idea of the re-deads. You know?
Yeah.
Mini blends? Yeah.
Yes.
Mini blends. Yes. And it's not a thing where you can just hide in a corner.
No. Okay, not mini blends. Those moblin statues on the walls shoot lasers.
Ah, no, yes. Yes, I like this idea.
One of them on each side of the room.
Oh, man.
So you have to stay in the middle of it.
Four corners of the room.
Man.
That would be so dumb. Although at that point, it's kind of impossible and seems unbalanced, but...
You would need to use magic armor as much as possible.
I have an idea. Instead of mini blends, we need a threat that is a little bit stronger than mini blends.
Mm-hmm.
Purple choo-choos, but there's no light in the room. But not a lot of them. Maybe one or two.
That would be brutal.
Okay.
And then defeating all the other enemies unlocks a beam
of light. Wow! Oh, wow! There are a lot of them. Hello! Wow. Oh, hi. Don't die. See, we mentioned the Weeping Angels, and if I haven't mentioned it before, I'm really a big Doctor Who fan. What would happen if you crossed the Weeping Angels with the Silence?
Weeping Angels you can't remember?
Yes. Oh, wow. These guys are...
So cute. When you blink, you forget about them, and you forget not to blink.
No, you don't forget not to blink. You just forget that they're there, so you look at them again, and they're there. You don't forget anything about... Well, actually, you do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you would forget to blink.
Yes.
Or to not blink. That would be...
That worked.
Just toss bombs in there.
No, I kind of like this. See?
Whoa.
Ha! Ha! This is perfect.
No, swing it. Swing it in a circle.
No, but this is fun because I get to see their stunned expressions. Also, if I swing it in a circle, they won't be stunned. This is cool. I feel like I'm playing whack-a-mole.
You are.
This is beautiful. I didn't realize the stun was global. Here, you die. You die. Oh, boy. There we go. You die. You die. You can die. Oh, wait, let's do this. You two. No, you. Yeah. This
You're
is fun.
You're having way too much fun
this.
With
is
this.
Really fun. Do 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 do.
Look at Link's face when he flies through the air.
That was fun. That was actually really, really cathartic. I felt like I was playing whack-a-mole. They pop up, I hit them, they die, and then I just kind of jump around on my killing spree. Killing sprees are fun, kids.
Be careful.
Actually, I saw a comment that made me laugh. Oh, wow. Whoa! That was a new animation. new. This game just came out. I saw a comment that made me laugh really hard. It was, you know the comments where it's like, don't do this, kids. Or this is fun, kids. Well, I saw a thing on one of the videos I watch where this guy had gotten an injury from another guy smoking next to him and then accidentally burning him with his cigarette.
Oh, that, yeah.
Right? And one of the comments was, this is why you don't smoke, kids. And someone said, he never mentioned smoking children.
Oh my
smoking,
word!
This is why you don't smoke, kids.
Oh my goodness!
And I laugh so hard, because that's such an, the instructions toward children is used so much. It was just beautiful. Also, I feel like these guys are patterned after rats. Just look at them scurry around everywhere. Or weasels or something. Okay, can you die?
I like the Bokoblin design in Wind Waker much more than Skyward Sword.
Oh, yeah, yeah. The Skyward Sword is just kind of... The redeeming quality is that they're much harder than these guys. You don't just mash B, you actually have to strategize.
Yeah, but they look so dumb.
It's
you can't take them seriously.
Then there's Toilet Princess, where they are seriously the dumbest enemies. They don't do anything.
Yeah.
You just beat them up. The only saving grace is that there's a purple Bokoblin in that game that takes forever to kill.
Hmm.
Oh. Actually, this is a really stupid combination. You see this, right?
Yeah. Our dream comp.
No, this isn't our dream comp. We didn't have these guys for an obvious reason. Because these guys will... The Stalfos will kill them. Here, I'm gonna show this.
Will they?
Yes.
Wait, re-swing.
Like that. See? It's kill... They're murdering each other.
Oh my goodness.
Look at the carnage. I have not hit anyone. In fact...
Oh my word.
It's they're chaos.
Two down.
It's chaos. It's like a bar fight.
It's an all-out ball. Might want to wait for him to get closer.
It's like the... It's like the mariachi song.
Run.
Okay, come here. Yeah, do your little roar thing. You missed me too! Come here, guys! You killed him!
No, I didn't.
Okay, swing it.
Oh my goodness!
This is beautiful! Come here! Come here, buddy.
Run.
Whatever dungeon designer there was, didn't really think too hard on this one.
He just got wombo-comboed.
That is amazing. Best moment in the LP right there. That is the highlight of the game. Okay, let's just kill this thing. Oh, I forgot you could do that. You see that?
Yep.
No, don't. You have to do that. You do that by spamming spin tag, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because they thought, you know, this would be OP. In fact, I'm going to do it here. Oh, my goodness.
Use a hurricane spin on him.
Ow. He's right next to a wall. Let's do this. Oh, I also forgot that if the legs are still standing when you take them apart, the legs will kick you.
Really?
Yeah. I forgot about that. Okay, come here. This is a really cool idea for an enemy. I could only imagine the boardroom here. Also, I don't really care about damage at this point because I have two fairies, I have a red potion, and I have an elixir soup.
And we're close to the end.
Yeah. I'm gonna take this, and I'm gonna name it Phil.
Speaking of which, we have a pretty epic Dark Nut fight coming
up.
Oh
yeah, in fact, this was my first introduction to Let's Play. This isn't it. Do you remember that?
No.
We commentated it. We filmed it with my iPod, and you don't remember that?
No, I do not.
We filmed it with my iPod when we first discovered that they do this, that there was a gigantic fight. Okay. That worked. I have a fairy, I'm good. I mostly kind of want to get these guys to kill them. There we go. Why did that not work? You didn't hit him. Okay, hit him this time. There we go! Killed both of them. Should I use a potion at this point, or should I rely on fairies?
Rely on fairies.
Okay. That was a cool attack.
Whoa.
And now I'm not gonna take any more hits. Beast mode. Oh, man. Don't hit me, please.
Get your parry attack ready.
Yes! Okay, now they're dead.
It's coming at you. Careful.
Oh, yes. Yeah, you're on fire. Feel the burn. Ha, you're on fire. Feel the burn. That is beast right there. He lived while on fire. Okay, let's do this. I think this is the final one? The final battle right here? My voice gets really high-pitched? Okay, you guys know. Oh, snap. Oh, that's fine. Okay, No.
Do you want to know how many floors you have left?
No. Oh, wow. Oh, they charged the walls. They charged the walls.
What?
Do you see that?
No.
They charge those things. That is... They're not playing anymore.
I don't remember seeing that before.
Also, black dark nuts are cool. Black dark nuts. They're awesome. Blackness is cool. Okay, you can lose your armor. And you can die. Yes. And I see that you're tough. I'm gonna hit you without even looking at you. And you're gonna die too. It's kind of weird how they have smithing bibs on.
aprons.
Thank you. Sniffing bibs. Bibs.
Really?
Sniffing apron. Smithing aprons. Not snipping or sniffing. Oh, wow. That's a wombo combo. Although, wait a minute. Really? That's not as bad as I thought it was going to be. I think this is another one where I'm just going to let them kill themselves. Yep, kill yourself, please. Yeah.
Wow.
Poor planning on their part. I have not actually landed a killing blow on any of them at this point. I think I can just hit bombs now and kill it. Yeah. They actually killed each other these last two times. Okay, there we go. Thank you. And you're dead. Oh, not again. Also out of arrows, almost out of everything. It's all a wreck. Okay, now you can die, this time for reals. There we go. Seriously, I have no cares about damage at this point, because I have another fairy, and I'm not concerned, which is why Zelda has flaws, because you take no damage. Oh.
It's the statues.
Four! We're doing this. Okay, spin attack time. Okay, get all together, please. Oh, they're all around the room.
And they breathe fire.
Okay, please take off the armor. Yeah, they breathe fire. Okay, wait. Okay, I have a fairy, right? Okay.
Yes.
So I'm gonna do this and then charge up a hurricane spin. Nope, okay, it didn't work. Why didn't it work? Okay, I think I'm gonna do up an elixir here. I love how he smiles for this and he doesn't smile for any of the others.
With that magic power, you should use the magic armor.
Yeah. Good idea.
Will that retain your chicken soup sword?
Yes. Why is it not hurting them? That's weird. That's really weird.
You better make good use of your magic power there.
It doesn't hurt them. Okay. Well,
maybe
I guess
it's their shields.
Yeah. I guess it's time to do this the good old fashioned way. Come on, hit me. There we go. I got almost all of their helmets. And I got hit. Now I'm going to see if I can do this.
You can't.
Yeah, that's weird. That's honestly really weird. Maybe it's just because they're too clumped up.
And they're pretty fast. They don't give
you any time to charge up. That got the armor that time. Okay, hit me. There we go. The parry attack is really OP. Oh man, that's unfortunate. Just gonna charge this up here. Yes! Yeah, you kill your best friends. Don't eat that sandwich. You watch the feature. Okay, no one else got that but you and me. You're like, what are you talking about? Is you just being random again? Yes, but Abbott and Costello humor. You watch the feature.
Brudda.
Abbott and Costello is amazing. Was that it?
That was
it. Wow.
Why is the room glowing blue?
Because it's pretty. It's very pretty. Okay, you guys ready? At the very end of this is the 87th stray bead or a piece of heart. We only need one more. One more. And we're done. One more. And we have all of them. And we might do that next episode, though I'm not sure. I think we might do that next episode just for sake of completion.
We could.
We could definitely do that. But I don't know. We'll find out then. Thank you guys so much for watching. And if you stuck with us this video, this...
Congratulations.
I have no clue how long video. It's getting on to be 40 minutes? Okay. Not much of that is being cut out either, so... Wow, 40 minutes. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you join us next time for another Pals Play Wind Waker. I release new episodes of Wind Waker Tuesdays and Fridays. Once again, I've said it enough, this series is wrapping up. Next time is Nova's episode, and we'll tackle something worthwhile. See you guys then.
See ya.